Now it's history. I've played all my cards, and that's what you've done too. Nothing more to say, no more race to play. The winner takes it all, the loser standing small beside the victory.
Good morning, Bucknutters. It's Tuesday, January 13th, 2015. I am Dan Rubin, and I guess I better address you as Bucknutters, devotees of the world champion, Ohio State Buckeyes. Ladies and gentlemen, it was a glorious experience. I had the extreme good fortune of being there last night, and I think you can hear that in my voice. Did not arrive back in the Gem City till about 4 a.m., so I'm just going to share with you today kind of my observations of the game, the glorious ride that it was, and just some things I picked up out of it. This won't be the most detailed BM5 ever, as most of the people that worked the game are likely somewhat catatonic at this point. So here's what stood out to me in yesterday's game overall, and I combine this with after watching the Buckeyes play Oregon, Alabama, Wisconsin. Ohio State has the best program in the country, and they have the best players in the country, and they have the best coach in the country. So there's that, which is a really good starting place if you're working with the program. There was not one point in the game yesterday when they played Oregon where I felt they got pushed around at all. Any of the mistakes or issues within the game were self-inflicted. At one point in time, the Buckeyes had 4 turnovers. Oregon had 0, and the Buckeyes had the lead. I don't remember the last time I've ever seen anything like that happening. I would like to give some kudos to certain people individually. I think the closet MVP or the sleeper MVP for this football team is offensive line coach Ed Warner. What he has done with this group of 5 guys who have never started in the spots they are in is nothing short of sensational. I thought they dominated the game yesterday. I thought they dominated the game pretty much against Alabama. Given where we came from at Virginia Tech, to have that take place is just totally incredible. Going into yesterday's game, I thought there were 3 keys to the game. Thankfully, they all worked out in Ohio State's favor. 1, I did not see any circumstance under which Oregon would be able to stop Ohio State's rushing attack. If you can put up what Easy did against Alabama, there's no reason to believe you can't do that and more against Oregon. And I think it's clear they did that. Instead of giving him 20 carries this week, Bax requested 28, and he got 36. So I'll take 36 anytime. The other part of this that I thought wasn't discussed enough was a kind of a new aspect of the playoff, is that these games are played back-to-back against big-time competition. I'm not sure Oregon's size and makeup of their roster was able to recover from that as well as Ohio State was able to recover from the Alabama game. It became very clear after they body-punched him to death with Easy early that those holes got bigger and bigger and bigger, and when you're on site, at least the way I was, you can tell when defensive backs come up and want a matador tackle, and that started happening on a very, very consistent basis. Other cool things I got to see. Before the game, I got to see Stacy Elliott ride a mechanical bull. That was awesome. His son went out there and then rode all the way over Oregon in impressive fashion. 3 guys I want to mention, obviously Eazy-E was tremendous. I'm not sure I've seen anybody have a precipitous rise as a football player the way he did this year. My guess is he will open next season as the favorite to win the Heisman Trophy and be the odds-on favorite to be the first running back selected in the draft. Thank God he's a true sophomore. He'd probably go now, and deservedly so. Got to talk about Cardale. What Cardale did yesterday was amazing. Yes, there were times when he looked a little bit befuddled, but he made 3 or 4 of the best 3 to 6 yard runs you will ever see. The 4th and short where he bounced outside and then dove for it was nothing short of sensational. I have no idea what's going to happen with Cardale going forward. We talked about this on the plane coming back. I could see him leaving for the NFL. I could see him coming back. I could see him transferring. He's certainly going to have his options in front of him, given the 3-star performance he had is arguably the best 3-star performance anybody's ever had in the history of the sport. And I also would love to mention Joey Bosa. At the end of the game, when we were in pin-our-ears-back mode, going after Mariota with the lead, we were even screaming out, "It's Joey Bosa time." The first play from scrimmage, the right tackle just decided, you know what, I have no interest in blocking Joey Bosa, so I'm going to tackle him. Bosa is a dominant force, who, by the way, is a sophomore, and he'll be back. That's just a few observations I had from being down there in Dallas. It was a tremendous experience. When we go next year, I encourage everybody to scrounge up what you can to get out there. It'll be worth it. My guess is we outnumbered the Ducks 70-30, and that's conservative in the stadium. The Buckeyes put forth an incredible performance as both a team and a fan base. We are the national champions. Nobody can take that away from us. Have an excellent day, Bucknutters.
Keep you down, you're the best around, and nothing's gonna